finally arrived here at the beautiful Warwick Castle. So now I'm up here, just walking up to the top where you can walk along the castle. And it's really pretty up here. Like, you can see basically everything. You can learn a little bit of history on the way up. I've gotten to this viewpoint where you can kind of see a little bit of it. Now we're at this viewpoint. So as we go up, kind of getting higher and higher. So just some background history on the castle itself. Warwick Castle was built by William the Conqueror in 1068 and was used as fortification until the early 17th century. It is a Mott and Bailey castle, just like Durham Castle. The Great Hall, which we are in now, is constructed in the 14th century and has had many uses since. It was rebuilt in the 17th century to serve as a grand entrance hall for visitors to the Earl of Warwick. So, the Great Hall also houses its arms and armor. It is one of the biggest collections of such artifacts. So now we're gonna go down into the jail where the prisoners went. So right here we're approaching the tower that we saw upon entry, and we're actually pretty high up now. We can actually kind of see the whole entire landscape of Warwick Castle. So now this is called Guy's Tower. So I'm gonna enter it and see what it's all about, because I'm really interested in the information. So that kind of wraps up my time here at Warwick Castle. I really enjoyed my time and learned a lot about their history. But now the coach is going to take us to our next stop, so I'll update you when we arrive there. So I didn't show you earlier, but this is actually the coach that we're taking from place to place. And the tour guide that we are using is Evan and Evan, and it's called the Warwick Castle Tour. And you take off from the Victoria coach station in London. So we just arrived to Stratford, and now we are going into Shakespeare's Birthplace and the museum. John Shakespeare lived and worked in this house for 50 years. When he married Mary Arden, she came to live with him, and they had a total of 8 children, including their son, William Shakespeare. The house doubled as a glover's shop where John worked at the eastern end of the building, with a barn and workshops in the backyard. John Shakespeare died in 1601, and as the eldest surviving child, William inherited the house. He leased part of the property and it became an inn, later called the Swan and Maidenhead. In the late 18th century, the house went up for sale and was purchased by the Shakespeare Birthplace Trust in 1847, and they've cared for it ever since. My time here in Stratford-Upon-Avon, and now I am gonna get back on the coach and we're gonna head towards Oxford and through the Cotswolds, so I'll update you then. The University of Oxford is roughly 922 years old, making it the second oldest university in the world. It was established in around the 11th century. The town of Oxford was named about AD 900 as a river crossing or ford for oxen. Ends off the day here in Oxford. I really enjoyed my day here and learned a lot of history about the universities. You should definitely visit a lot of different universities in England because you'll learn a lot of history that you may have not known of before. Whoa!